guys to another HubSpot local development tutorial for today. This is the part two series. So in this video, I'm going to show you how you can fetch or download your files from your HubSpot Designer tools or manager going to your local computer. And this is specifically for if you use the Visual Studio Code. However, the process is just the same. You just need to put the right syntax in your terminal. So yeah, it's all about downloading files from HubSpot going to your local computer. But if you are, you are curious, you haven't tried local development yet. So if you are curious about that, then I would recommend that you check my part one series. So it's my part one series is really a get-go. It's all about like how you can install the CMS, how you can upload your files from your local computer going to your HubSpot account, how you can install your boilerplate. So I would suggest if you haven't tried that one, then check my part one series for that. Anyway, without further ado, let's begin. 1, 2, 3. So this will be the part two series of my HubSpot development. Now, in this video, you will learn how you can download or fetch your HubSpot files from your HubSpot portal, okay? So if you are new to HubSpot local development, the CMS, the CLI, then I would recommend that you check my other video, and I call it HubSpot local development guide for beginners. So this is the part one series of my local development in HubSpot. Now, just check that out if you are you haven't tried any local development yet in HubSpot. Okay, I'm gonna dive in now to my Visual Studio. Okay, so first is I created a folder, so I called it just test HubSpot folder. Okay, and then I installed the HubSpot CMS platform using this syntax. Again, this is included on my part one series, so you need to check that out. Now, next is we will start fetching our files from HubSpot portal to our local computer. So, okay. So in order to do that, you just need to type in npx hs init. Actually, this is also included in my part one, but yeah, let's just authenticate first, okay? Once you run the npx, the init command, there will be a package called that.json that will be generated. And if you hit continue, you will go to the HubSpot portal to connect your personal access, okay? So I'm gonna log in using my Gmail account, and then I will, Now I'm gonna get my personal access, okay? So continue, and you will be redirected to the personal key. If you want to do the manual way, then that is also fine. There is a documentation for that on HubSpot. I'm gonna put it as well on the link on the description below for more information. So copy the personal access, and then you put it here, okay? And this will connect your HubSpot portal to your local computer. So enter a unique name to reference your account. So you can name whatever you want, actually. This is just for your naming purposes, but I'm gonna call that BookwormHead. So, And this will authenticate the process. So as you can see here, success config, they already connected to each other. Now we can start running a command called npx hs fetched, and then something like that. For the Apple, I think you can just put hs fetch, and then there's no space for the for this one. Okay, again, I'm gonna put the syntax on the link description as well, or I'm gonna create a blog version for this for documentation. But HubSpot documentation are really good already, so feel free to check their I really recommend that you check their documentation for more information. Okay, so I'm gonna type in that. So currently it is fetching the files. Okay, as you can see here, it's fetching. Now we will compare the files here since it's still since the files are still downloading. We will compare the files from our local computer to our HubSpot. Let me pause this for a while. Somebody's calling me. Okay, hold on. Okay, so I'm gonna go to my HubSpot account, and then I will. So it's still recording. HubSpot. And then I will go to the designer tools. Okay, and these are the files from my computer. And if you compare that on my Visual Studio, you will see that it is working. I mean, it is, they copied from files from my HubSpot local computer to my from my HubSpot portal to my local computer. Now we will start. Let's say, for example, I'm gonna do some changes. I'm not so sure if I mentioned this on my part one series, but yeah, let's just recap this one. So for example, let's dive into the about section. Okay, this one, about section. Let me clear my terminal. Sorry. So in the about section, I'm gonna go to the system. I'm sorry, it is in the Bookworm head, and then templates, and then system, and then, okay, let's say for example, I will change some context from about that HTML. And I want to make sure that every time I make changes in my local computer, the portal will also update. So how you can do that? Okay, to do that, you need to watch your files first. So I will call that npx hs watch, if I'm not mistaken, or probably it's only one hyphen, but yeah, let's just try. And then what's the name of the folder that you want to watch? So BookwormHead for the source file, and then BookwormHead for the HubSpot portal. And then you will, yeah, so let's gonna do that. npx hs watch. Okay, the argument is wrong. I think it's npx hs just watch. I think there's no something like this. Bookworm head. Hopefully that will work. So it's currently watching. Now I'm gonna make changes on my about a section, and let's name it, instead of meet our team, I'm gonna call it meet Angelique, and then control S to save it. Now it's already updating. They upload a files from my local computer to my HubSpot. Now I will refresh my portal in HubSpot, and let's go to the about section and see. Okay, as you notice in here, it's already meet Angelique Sanoi. Now, the other thing as well I want to tackle is what if I'm going to remove a certain file? I want to clean my HubSpot files that are not necessary. So how you can do that, okay? To do that, you can also do hsnpx watch, and then let's say bookworm head, and just add the extension called remove. Oh, I see. Because I've, let me try to open the documentation in here. So local computer, local HubSpot development. So let's type in HubSpot. It's called, I just forgot the name. It's fetched. Okay. Not fetch, sorry, it should be watched. I haven't seen the documentation. Let me pause this for a while. I just forgot the sandbox, but it should be in here. Gotcha. It's the typo. It should be npx hs watch. It's not HSNPX, so it's NPX HS watched bookworm head, and then removed. See? So currently it is watching. Now I want to delete this about.html. I don't think this is necessary. So let's try to click the delete, move to the recycle, and then I will refresh my HubSpot designer page. Let's go into the bookworm head and the layouts. And if you notice in here, the about.html is already gone. So that is, there's still a lot of syntax, there's still a lot of command you can use. Just check out the local development documentation in HubSpot. It's super helpful. By the way, this is for the authentication. If you don't want to do the automatic connection, then they do also have this part. So you just need to change your YAML or YML. So someone's called it YAML. So that's it. I hope guys you find this helpful. Let me know which part do you think would be helpful for you to expedite your web development process in HubSpot. On my part, I love the fetch thing. It's really helped me to download all the files and just replicate it on other templates so I can reuse the modules. So that's it, guys. Thank you so much. And don't forget to subscribe, hit the bell notification, and thumbs up if you want to see more videos from BookwormHead.